In this video, we are going to discuss about the classification of kingdom Animalia. So, animals are classified into two types, into two groups on the basis of the presence and absence of notochord. So, if notochord is absent, they are called as non-chordates. Non-chordates. If notochord is present, they are called as chordates. Now, what is notochord? Notochord is basically a cartilaginous rod-like structure which supports the body. So, here they don't have a notochord in their lifetime. Here, in chordates, they have a notochord. There is presence of notochord. Notochords include the first phylum, which is Porifera. So the groups in kingdom Animalia or animal kingdom, these are called as phylum. Each one is called phylum and many are called as phyla. In plant kingdom, the groups are called as divisions. Here they are called as phyla. Now this in non-chordates include the first phylum, which is Porifera. Porifera includes sponges. So, we can write example as sponges, but if you have to be more specific, examples include like cycon, spongilla, etc. So, this is the first one, that is Porifera. The second one, this is the first phylum. The second phylum is Cnidaria or Coelenterata. So, this includes Hydra, Aurelia, which is jellyfish, etc. This is the second phylum. The third phylum is Ctenophora. Ctenophora. This is the third phylum. The fourth phylum is called as Platyhelminthes. Platyhelminthes. Platyhelminthes, this particular phylum includes animals like flatworms. Flatworms. So, as the name suggests here, platy means flat, helminth means something which is worm. So, platyhelminthes means includes flatworms like tapeworms, something like that. The fifth phylum is called as Nematoda or Ascyhelminthes. So there are two names here, Nematoda or Ascyhelminthes. This basically includes roundworms. Here Platyhelminthes has flatworms, so here also name suggests that they are flat. Nematoda, it includes roundworms, that means the worms are round in shape, they are circular in shape. The sixth phylum is called as Annelida. Annelida. Annelida includes animals such as earthworms like Ferratima, Lumbricus. There are many other examples of earthworms and leeches. Leech. So these kind of worms, they come under Annelida, this phylum. The seventh phylum is called as Arthropoda. Arthropoda. So, here also, this Arthropoda, this phylum includes animals which have jointed appendages. So, Arthropoda includes examples we can write as insects, like cockroaches, those all kind of things. And, yeah, it includes many insects. So, Arthropoda is the largest phylum in animal kingdom, that we need to remember. And in Arthropoda also, there are many other classes like Insecta, Chilopoda, and many other classes are there. In that, Insecta is the largest class in it. So, Arthropoda includes many insects. The eighth phylum is called as Mollusca. Mollusca includes gastropods, which are commonly known as snails. So snails which have shells, those come under mollusca. The ninth phylum which we are going to talk about is called as Echinodermata. Echinodermata. Here also the name suggests echino means spiny. Dermata means skin. That means there is a spiny skin. Example we can take here as starfish. Starfish is an example of echinoderms. And the tenth one is called as hemichordata. Hemichordata. Now, here we are talking about non-chordates, and here chordates. Then why is this particular phylum called hemichordata? If it is hemichordata, it needs to be here, right? But hemichordata, we usually refer it to as the connecting link between non-chordates and chordates. That means it possesses some characteristics of non-chordates and some characteristics of chordates. So this is hemichordata. So these are non-chordates. Non-chordates are the animals. Non-chordates are the animals which don't have notochord. So there is no notochord which is present during their lifetime. And what is notochord? Notochord is a cartilaginous rod-like structure which supports the body. So here we have discussed about non-chordates. Let us come to chordates. So chordates are the animals that have notochord. Now chordates can be classified into three groups on the basis of where is this notochord. On the basis of the presence of notochord. So where, in what location the notochord is. If the notochord is there in the tail region, they are called as urochordata. If they are in the head to tail region, these are called as cephalochordata. Cephalochordata or chordates. And the third group is called as vertebrata. So in case of vertebrata, the notochord completely turns into the vertebral column. So vertebrata, that's what they're called as vertebrata. Here the notochord turns into vertebral column. So chordates divided into three types: urochordata, cephalochordata and vertebrata. Vertebrata or vertebrates are further classified into two groups. Based on the presence of jaws. So if they have jaws, they are called something. If they don't have jaws, they are also called something. We are going to take a look at that now. So vertebrata, these are classified on the basis of the presence or absence of jaws. If they don't have jaws, they are called as agnathostomes. Agnathostomes. And if they have jaws, they are known as gnathostomes. So here the letter A is added here. That means A is something that refers to absence of. So here there is absence of jaw. That's why they're called as agnathostomes. If they have jaws, they're simply called as gnathostomes. So here we can write that they have jaws. Gnathostomes can be further classified into two groups on the basis of their locomotory structures. What structures do they use for their locomotion? If they use fins for their locomotion, they are called as Pisces. In Pisces, we include fish. So fish is another name for Pisces. The phylum Pisces includes fish. If they have limbs as their locomotory structure, these are called as tetrapoda. So tetrapoda, if they have limbs. So Pisces have fins as their locomotory structure. They come under Pisces. So Pisces includes fish mostly. Tetrapoda, this is a group in which their locomotory structure are limbs. So limbs consist of hands and legs. This tetrapoda, so these have limbs. This tetrapoda is again classified into four groups. And we all know what are these. The first one is called as amphibia. The second one is called as reptilia. The third one is called as apes, which consists of birds. So apes are also known as birds. And the last one is mammalia, which includes mammals. So here also the name suggests amphibia includes amphibians like frogs, which have dual nature. They live on both land and water. Reptilia, reptiles like snakes and crocodiles. Apes like birds, like sparrows, parrots, etc. Mammalia, which includes mammals. And here humans come under this thing. So humans come under mammalia and humans are tetrapods. They have limbs, so we have hands and legs. And humans are natostomes, that means we have jaws. And humans are vertebrates, because the notochord completely turns into the vertebral column. And we are chordates, that means we have notochord. But why are we telling that we are chordates? Because we know that our notochord completely turns into the vertebral column. But we have notochord during the embryonic stage. After when we grow, the notochord completely changes into vertebral column. Now here we are specifying that the animals are divided into two categories, non-chordates and chordates. Non-chordates are the animals that don't have notochord in their lifetime. They don't even possess that kind of structure. Chordates, these are the animals that possess notochord in any time. So during any time of their lifetime, they possess it. So humans, they show this presence of notochord during their embryonic stage. And that's why we told here we kept humans under vertebrata, because the notochord changes into vertebral column. So here natostomes, this is clear. And Pisces consists of fish. And here also we include bony fish and cartilaginous fish. So these are the two types of fish that include in Pisces. Tetrapoda, which have limbs, these are divided into four categories: amphibia, reptilia, apes or birds, mammalia. So here humans come under this category. So this is all about the classification of kingdom Animalia. Let's go over it again. Non-chordates include porifera, which are sponges, cnidaria, example hydra, ctenophora, platyhelminthes, example. Here also we can take one example in ctenophora. Example is ctenoplana. So this is a small example of ctenophora. Platyhelminthes, these include flatworms. Nematoda, these include roundworms. Annelida, these include earthworms and leeches kind of organisms. Arthropoda includes insects. Mollusca includes, here we can write some more. Arthropods includes insects, millipedes, centipedes, and many more. So we know that Arthropoda is the largest phylum in animal kingdom. This is very important. And eighth one is Mollusca, which includes snails, which are usually called as gastropods. Ninth one is Echinodermata, which have spiny kind of skin. Example, starfish. And the tenth one is Hemichordata, which is a connecting link between non-chordates and chordates. They possess some characteristics of non-chordates and some characteristics of chordates. So here we have already taken a look at chordates. Eurochordata, cephalochordata, vertebrata. Eurochordata is where the notochord is present in the tail region. Cephalochordata is where the notochord is present in the head to tail region, vertebrata is when the notochord is completely turned into vertebral column. These are divided into two, agnathostomes, natostomes, on the basis of the presence or absence of jaws. This is again divided into two on the basis of their locomotory structures. Here they have fins as their locomotory structure. Here they have limbs as their locomotory structure, like hands and legs. And this is again divided into four: amphibia, reptilia, apes, and mammalia. So this is all about the classification of kingdom Animalia. These are all the phylums that we take into consideration. So here we have Porifera, Cnidaria, Cnidaria or Coelenterata, Ctenophora, Platyhelminthes, Nematoda, Annelida, Arthropoda, Mollusca, Echinodermata, Hemichordata, and Vertebrata. So these are the 11 phyla. 11 phyla that we take into consideration when we are talking about kingdom Animalia. So this is all about the classification of animal kingdom or kingdom Animalia.